Guys, the first fully autonomous vehicle crash just happened in China, and it's sparking massive outrage in China. But it's not for the reason you're thinking of. So most autonomous vehicles that we see or we're exposed to are actually vehicles like my Neo over here. There's actually a driver inside, right? Monitoring everything, and then the car's driving by itself. But what you didn't know is that Meituan, which is actually listed by the way, they have been testing out and deploying their fully autonomous robot delivery vehicles. Now these are just tiny little cars that drive by itself from destination to destination, delivering food, and they're very, very small. There's no driver inside. It's fully autonomous. You can't fit a person in there even if you wanted to. Maybe a leprechaun. And these things drive very, very slow. They drive 4 kilometers per hour. Super, super slow. But that's the whole point. The slower, the safer. They've done extensive testing so that, you know, the car won't actively hit on other stuff, like other people's vehicles or oncoming people. But what has happened recently is that there's been an accident where this car, this white car, has hit onto Meituan's delivery vehicle, causing this accident. Now, and why is this sparking massive outrage, you're thinking? Let me explain. You gotta pay attention. You gotta understand what's going on, all right? I gotta tell you the full picture. Delivery car was just driving straight, right? It's just driving straight, and then the white vehicle turned into its lane and hit the delivery car, right? Usually, it's always the guy that's turning into the lane, their fault, right? Whoever's turning into the lane and you hit someone, that's your fault. The guy going straight, they're not at fault at all, right? They're just going straight, and you think that way as well, right? This is the white car's fault, man. You rammed into that delivery car, but what happened was, the law ruled that the delivery car was at fault because the delivery car was in the bike lane. The bike lane. Meituan had to pay all the fines and fees and repairs for the white vehicle. This is sparking massive outrage online because of the fact that, you know, by definition of this ruling, then that means the delivery cars are supposed to be driving on the main road. Now, if they're driving on the main road and they're going at 4 kilometers per hour, that's a huge safety hazard, isn't that? Right? You're going maybe 40 kilometers an hour, and then there's a yellow car over there that's going 4 kilometers an hour, super slow. That's a pretty big driving hazard. Now, the white driver has also been taking some smack online. People saying, hey, it's traveling so slow, even a grandpa could avoid it, man. What the hell's wrong with you? But this just indicates a huge, huge problem here in China. And that problem is that the law is falling behind of the technology, right? The technology for autonomous driving is advancing so fast that the laws can't keep up. There aren't the necessary laws to regulate what happens if a car that's driving by itself has some sort of traffic violation. People are pissed because the laws on this matter aren't that clear, and they wish that this can be cleared up soon, because we are seeing more and more of these delivery cars and autonomous vehicles in our daily lives, like it or not, and the laws need to keep up. And what's the most worrying thing about this is that even in the future, right, when there's full self-driving for Teslas, full self-driving for Neos, full self-driving for other vehicles, the laws might not even be in place for people to be able to use them. There aren't specified laws in regards to what happens if the vehicle is driving by itself and then something happens. And there aren't laws to regulate how safe or unsafe L4 driving should be. Very, very basic analogy is the crash test, right? All cars have to go through basic crash testing and be able to pass basic crash tests. But where is this sort of test for autonomous driving? The law is really, really behind the tech. And even once the tech is mature enough to be used, the laws might not be in place to allow it to be used. What do you guys think about this whole entire situation? Because this does mean that a lot of EV companies that have fully autonomous driving
might not be able to use them.
What do you guys think of this whole situation? And who do you think is at fault here? the yellow car that should be driving in the main road or the white car for bumping into the yellow car. Stay safe, stay healthy. Peace out.